Attention to details are vital in a real estate transaction, particularly when it comes to a contract. It's very important that the earnest money deposit is received and deposited with a proper entity, such as the title company, attorney, or a broker's escrow account. You just don't keep it in your purse, which is actually illegal, and the day of closing, bring it. The reason this is important is if you have a buyer in a transaction and you're selling your home, there's an earnest money deposit for escrow deposit for $5,000. If that buyer doesn't perform, you can actually keep that money. So it's important that the money is actually delivered. Also, inspection days. You don't want this to be loosey-goosey or 30 days. You want to have it nailed down to a short time period to get that behind us. Now, one of the most important things is a loan commitment period. And typically, real estate agents will have a contract for 30 days and they have a loan commitment for 30 days. So what is a loan commitment? That's basically where the lender says, this guy's good or this gal's good, we can loan the money. And it's at that point where the seller can start packing and moving. So if you've got a contract for 30 days and the loan commitment time period, which means the time period the buyer has to deliver a loan commitment is also 30 days, that means the buyer could show up the day of closing and say, I'm sorry, my loan was denied. And guess what? You packed your whole house, you moved everything out, you're in the new place, and you find out the day of closing. So you actually need to properly negotiate that and document it in the contract. Now, when it comes to any questions regarding the contract or interpreting the contract, a real estate agent needs to refer that to an attorney. So we can help you negotiate the contract, fill out the terms and so forth, but when it comes to actually interpreting the contract, what it means, you would need to talk to an attorney.